Well, I'm getting up in years, and I have a friend that, or two friends that we fish together. We graduated high school together, and now we're fishing together again. But our biggest problem with our old age is we sit in a boat for a while, and we get all stiff and bound up. And one night, my buddy Harlan, he fell in the river, and then I was getting out of the boat, and I fell in the river. So we just got one to go now. Mr. Pence's day will come. We're gonna have to push him in the river, I think.
Rivers meander through the lives of everyone. Rivers and streams connect all of us. Water knows no city boundaries, county boundaries, state boundaries, or property boundaries. We are the rivers, and the rivers are us.
My mom wouldn't let me go down by the Cedar River when I was little, but she let me go to a stream called Prairie Creek. It was about the size of this stream. Starting when I was about 8 years old, I got to go down there by myself. It was about a mile from my house, and I'd walk down there with my friends, and we'd walk around in the woods, and we'd build forts, wade in the creek, built rafts that always sunk. So you never wanted to be the first person to test the raft. But we had a great time.
Sources of abundance and destruction, life and death, creativity and imagination. Rivers and the fresh flowing waters are at the heart of human existence.
Rush Creek, to me, has kind of been a blessing and a curse. On a day like today, it's a good place to come down to and kind of recharge your batteries. Just the beauty of it to me, even though I've been here over 30 years, the newness hasn't wore off. When it's wild, when it gets, you know, the flood stage, she does do a lot of damage.
Rivers and streams are so interwoven into our lives that at times we don't even see them.
One thing I found when I first brought students down here was that when I said we were going to the river, they said, well, what river? And I said, well, we're going down to the park just down the hill. And they said, oh, that's not a river. They called it a ditch. They called it a creek. They were very surprised, or at least some of them were very surprised when I said that, no, this was a river. We showed them on the map how this river actually flowed to Des Moines.